Gavin, I'm here in Manchester at the Manchester City training ground, joined by Terry Flanagan. Terry, you know, how you doing?
Yeah, I'm good. Just done the press conference now. Looking forward to the big night.
I mean, I look around the training ground and it is a very impressive setup, you know. Does it ever make you wish that you've gone into the sport of football rather than boxing?
I used to do a bit of football when I was younger.
Yeah,
I thought I liked it, but it's either boxing or football, and I chose the other one.
I mean, how closely do you follow the sport, and how closely do you follow, you know, Man City?
Yeah, the season took a hold of it, and yeah, I've been all over Europe watching City, and yeah, I'm a big fan, massive fan.
Back into your training camp now, you know, how's it been going? And you know, you've had a nice break over Christmas and the new year until your fight was announced.
Yeah, I mean, I've been seeing a bit away. I've been training for about 4 weeks now. I've been back in 4 weeks. Went away last week, done a bit of warm weather training just for a week, just to, before camp started proper. I mean, eight hard solid week now. I'm half fit and just get that next level of fitness and push on now for the fight.
I mean, you'll be fighting back in Manchester after a couple of defences in Cardiff. You know, how much are you looking forward to coming back to your hometown?
Yeah, I'm looking forward to it because every time I box there, I put on a show and a performance. Every time I box there, I've got the knockout, so looking to keep that run going.
I mean, really, since Ricky Hatton, you know, he was followed everywhere by Manchester boxing fans. You know, what do you think it is that fans from this area just follow the boxers through thick and thin and are always there?
I think back in the day when Ricky was about, I mean, City was probably second, first division, and they didn't have much to cheer about, so the fans jumped on it then. But now we're going for Premier League and Champions League and stuff like that, so they've got that. So hopefully, yeah. Few of them can jump on the back of me and put on some great nights like Ricky did.
I mean, you're taking on Petrov, you know, what are you expecting him to bring in the fight?
I'm expecting a tough fight. I mean, he's a great fighter. He comes to a fight. We know we're not 100% on it. Could slip up, so we know we're going to be in a fight. It's going to be a hard 12 rounds and it's tough. We don't get stopped. He's been stopped once off Maidana. That was at late notice. And at a weight above, so yeah, I mean, we know what to expect. He's tough, he's whirling, and he's gonna come, he's gonna bring it.
I mean, there's been a lot of talk of potential fights towards the end of the year, such as Anthony Crolla if he beats Jorge Linares.
They always get talked about these fights, so there's always another fight being talked about after this, but first and foremost, you have to deal with what's in front of you, and that's what I'm looking at doing.
How difficult can it be just to make sure that you do stay focused on the task at hand?
Not really for me, no, not at all, because I know slip up and fights what are getting talked about never happen, and it won't happen anyway. Even if you confirm it'll be someone else and win this one, and then this can happen, and win this one, this can happen. So it don't really matter, you just got to beat who's in front of you, and that's what I'll do.
I mean, on Petrov, you know, have you watched any of his past fights or his clips just to see what he could bring?
Yeah, I've watched a few of his fights. I mean, I've watched a lot of him. I mean, some of his performances have been good, some of them have been bad, and you think, going off that performance, I'd stop him, and then if you watch the next one, you think, fuck, you know, he's half all right, him. So, yeah, it don't matter, it's all different. You can watch what you want, but when you're in there, it's all different.
What does he bring to the fight that you haven't had to face before?
He's just going to have relentless pressure, throws a lot of shots, and he's busy, tough, can punch a bit. But yeah, it's same as any fight really, it don't really matter. Once you're in there, you can sort of adjust to what they've got, and that's what I want to do.
I know we just touched it briefly earlier, and you don't want to go into it because you're concentrating on this fight, but yeah. If you win, you know, what names do you have your eye on for towards the later part of this year?
I could say any one of the unification fights. Robert Easter, Michael Garcia, winner of Linares Crolla, simple.
I mean, the talk of the Crolla Linares fight, if, say, Anthony didn't win, would you be more than happy to take on Jorge Linares?
Yeah, more than happy. That's a fight I want. Like I say, unification fight, I want the winner.
then obviously if Anthony was to win, you know, that could be a huge fight for Manchester, you know, a battle of Manchester, you could call it.
Of course, that'd be massive. I mean, it'd be
a red and blue as well.
Yeah, red and blue, unification fight. It's just a big, massive fight, but I don't really want to think about that fight because I can't see the fight happening, so there's no point in even talking about it.
Why do you think you can't see the fight happening?
Just for, like I say, different promotional sides, and I don't really think his team wants it, so it won't happen if they don't want it. I mean, I think Anthony would jump at the chance of the fight, but yeah, his team don't seem to fancy it.
Do you think it's just because they don't believe that he could beat you if you got into the ring with him?
Yeah, I think that's the case. I mean, boxing is boxing. It's a genuine 50-50 fight. I don't think the bookies would be able to spot us. But yeah, I think it's a 50-50 fight and his team on a 60-40 fight, really.
Obviously, the other opponent is obviously Jorge Linares, like we were talking about. He's beating Kevin Mitchell, showed how tough he was in that fight, obviously beat Anthony first time round. You know, what would you have to do if you took him on? You know, what is it that Anthony even has to do to improve on?
Just put it on him and take him out. I mean, once you hit him clean on the chin, he's going, he's fragile. He's a good boxer, he's flashy. He picked some of the rounds up by just showing that little bit more class than Anthony in the last fight. And, yeah, he ended up winning the last three rounds, and if he wouldn't have won one of them, it probably ended up a draw. So I thought I had Linares by a few rounds, but like I say, he won the fight by just experience, really, and showing, knowing how to catch the judge's eye at the end of the round and stuff like that in a close round. So yeah, I think I'm confident of beating him.
I mean, there's even been a talk of even Vasyl Lomachenko stepping up. I mean, would that be a fight for you that you'd be loving to take on?
Yeah, like I said, I want to box the best, and he's probably up there pound for pound the best. So, yeah, I'd jump at the chance because he's going to go down in probably Hall of Fame, and you want to test yourself against the best. And the likes of Mayweather, Pacquiao, if they were still about, I'd want to fight them, or anyone, even the likes of Del Hoyo back in the day, I wanted to test myself against them. So yeah, it's good to have these names being mentioned with me, because I'm the champ also, and he's the champ below. If he wants a chance to fight for my title, he's heard the doors open.
And then also on your card, you got Liam Smith versus Liam Williams. It's great fight, that, isn't it? How can you see that one planning out?
It's a tough fight. I mean, they're both good kids. I mean, William Smith is probably technically better, but William's probably hits harder, so it's hard to call. If he had to put a pound on it, I'd probably say Smith would nick it on points, but like I say, they're both great kids, and made the best man win.
And then you also have Nicola Adams making her pro debut. How great is it that women's boxing is being given the chance to grow with the biggest promoters in the country backing it?
Yeah, I mean, Nicola's a top girl. I mean, I used to spar with her out with all college when I was up there training. She used to come down with Alwyn, and we'd have some good spars when I was a lot smaller. So, yeah, it's great. It's good that... It's good for the sport, really.
And then to end on, you know, what would you like to achieve by the end of the year?
To hold all the belts in my division, at least another one. But yeah, hopefully unify with another belt.
Yeah.